Hello there, I've got a quick video for you on config files and PC gaming. How you can use config files to get a little bit more FPS, therefore pushing your FPS perhaps just that little bit higher. Maybe it'll take you over the 120 you need for your 120Hz monitor. Maybe it'll take you over the 60 you need on your low-end card. I don't know. It's going to help either way, so, you know, check it out. Let me know what you think, and let's get started. So, what's a config file? Config file is basically, it's a text document, but with the extension CFG, and it has a bunch of commands in it that you would have to enter physically yourself every time you start the game into the console, because they're not in the menu system. There's still things you can tweak that you can turn on and off that the game developers have allowed us to do, but they're not in the graphical menu that you see. Okay, the config file will stop you having to enter them yourself every single time you start the game. So it allows us to perhaps set a few more settings. This is nothing new. PC gamers have been doing it for years, and it's perfectly safe. And in fact, servers tend to be able to turn these sorts of things on and off in most games if they don't want you to use them. Granted, not in Battlefield 4 because it's more controlled by the devs, but the point is that if they didn't want you to do it, it wouldn't be in there. It does give a slight advantage, but only so much as, you know, maybe turning everything to low so you've got less leaves on the trees. Yes, it gives an advantage, but it's an advantage everyone has the ability to do. So, I'm going to show you my config file. I'm going to give you a couple of links to Simthic.com where you can perhaps tweak your graphic settings. There's a great thread over there that explains each graphical setting and how many frames it may cost you, that kind of thing. And I'm also going to give you a link to a thread where it explains each command that you could put into the console and what it may or may not do, and might even give you FPS cost on that one as well. Okay, the config I've used, I've basically gone over to the Simthic thread and read through things and found people that have said, oh, this worked for me and that worked for me, and I've stuck it in a config file. It's as simple as that. What I can say and what I should say is this is not a one-size-fits-all fix, okay? Not everything here is going to be amazing for you. Maybe it is. Let me know below. Either way, I'd like to hear from you, but don't expect miracles. It's as simple as that. So here we are in my Battlefield 4 install directory. There you go. Mine's J, yours may be C, I don't know. But anyway, my Battlefield 4 install directory. I'm going to create a text document. So I'll right click, find new, go to text document, and I'll call it user.cfg. There we go. Now, it's going to ask me this because I'm giving it a CFG and I'm converting it from a text document. If this doesn't happen for you, it's likely that it's going to save it as a text document. So just keep that in mind, but I'm going to say yes, I want it to be a config file. And if you can, I'm assuming you can see there, so it says config file. And, well, you can kind of see that it's ready to open with Notepad, but again, that's because I've done this before. So what you'll find is when you double click this to put in the commands, you're probably going to get told that it doesn't know what to open it with. So choose Notepad. WordPad works, I guess, but Notepad's a bit safer. It doesn't add any hidden characters that perhaps you don't want. So config file, I'm going to double click it. I'm going to paste in my commands and I'm going to click save. Now, assuming it didn't do this and it saved itself as a text file, which I'll do now. Okay, it saved itself as a text file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, in Windows 8, really simply, go up to the top, find the View tab, go across to the file extension, the file name extensions, and for you, it's likely to be unchecked. So check it. And that will allow me to see the .txt on the end. Click it, get rid of the .txt, and click somewhere else, and there you go, it's done. Easy fix. Now in Windows 7, you're going to have to go to Folder Options or Folder Tools, I can't remember exactly, it's been a while, and check the box that says Show File Extensions for Known File Types, and that will allow you to do the same thing, okay? Or you can go and download it from me on my Google Drive, which I'll link in the description. So, yeah, that's probably easier than messing around. But if you want to do it this way, then by all means do it this way. And that's it. Done. Okay, so here's my before shot, if you like. This is with the game running at ultra, and you'll get to see the FPS. And I know you've just seen me put the config in the folder, but this is the miracle of editing for you. Okay, so this is now my after shot. This is again running in ultra, as you can probably see. But now let's check out the FPS. And as you can see, there's definitely a benefit to me applying the config file there. But actually, I don't see a difference in how it looks. Now, I know this isn't the best place for you to see that difference. So try it out. You can take the config file out and see whether there's a difference. And if you believe that the config file is a problem and it's changing your graphics too much, then take some of the commands out. Try it out for yourself. Don't just, like I say, don't just copy and paste this, guys. One size doesn't fit all. So try it out for yourself, see how you get on, let me know below, and hopefully this will help you get a little bit more FPS. Really sorry, console guys, that this wasn't for you, but you know what? You don't need this sort of thing. You've already got the 60 FPS you need, or the 30 FPS that you need to run the game as is. PC gamers, we got to tweak things a bit more to try and get it. So, yeah. Anyway, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching. I've been Shaved Ape, and I'll see you later.